We've decoded the disc that the Major brought back with her. It contained the blueprints for a mass retaliation weapon, codenamed V2. A far more powerful weapon than the two tactical nukes that the Belt had used in the last war. It was never fully developed at the time, but it appears that they've secretly completed its construction in the 15 years since the war. The V2 is a MIRV missile. It can wipe out half of all the large cities in either Osea or Yuktobanya. So where would they deploy it? It had to be in the Sol, which was also secretly completed and is now operational. After all, it was built to function as an orbital platform for such weapons in the first place. The Sol itself is unmanned, and what's concerning, the intelligence of Andromeda tracked down the origin of Shantae's transmissions to the Arkbird. It's in the former South Belka, a state entrusted to Ocean rule, and now called North Ocean. To be more precise, the transmission...
This will probably be the last time this ship launches an aircraft. So go ahead and pick the best plane we got in here.
Pick whatever you want. We'll catapult it into the sky. We're gonna get you up there no matter what, all right?
Captain, please choose my plane.
Captain, please choose a plane for me to pilot.
Captain, which plane should I use? We're launching with this formation then?
Rosgrease, launch!
Second wave of missiles inbound! 10 seconds to impact! Counter with artillery barrage! We can't hit all of them! Brace for impact!
We've been hit by 2 sub-launch missiles! The ship's listing!
Launch them out!
We can't! The ship's listing heavily to starboard! We're sinking fast!
Continue with the launch!
What?
Take them up. Hurry up with the catapult. Just concentrate on launching them. All hands not conducting aircraft launch, abandon ship immediately.
We're getting you guys into the air no matter what! I don't care what happens to the catapult!
Lost time and time again, but now I finally won.
Huh?
Look, we launched them off safely. There's my victory. As long as they're in the air, I haven't lost. And I know they'll succeed.
Yeah.
The captain was humming a tune. The same song I heard from the anti-war audience in the stadium. He was the one playing that record in the middle of a sea battle.
This is President Harlan of the Ocean Federation. Attention, all Ocean and Yuktobanian officers and soldiers currently on the battlefield. Let us put down our guns and come out of the trenches. The Ocean capital of Alred has been freed of the people who took advantage of my absence to usurp control of the country. Once robbed of my freedom and of my ability to do the right thing, I now stand again under the light of the golden sun, and I do so with the Honorable Yuktobanian Prime Minister Nicanor by my side. We have resolved our terrible and unfortunate misunderstandings, and the war is now over.
This is Prime Minister Nicanor, Head of Government for the Union of Yuktobanian Republics. Attention all officers and soldiers of Osia and Yuktobania currently on the battlefield. Please watch as President Harlan and I stand shoulder to shoulder, hand in hand. President Harlan's words are true. The war is over, but there is one more battle that still needs to be fought.
We believe that those who have tried to stir hatred between us are now preparing a weapon that could wipe out half of all metropolitan areas in either one of our countries. Our comrades are in flight as I speak, determined to stop this plan dead in its tracks. Which country is under the threat of mass destruction? That we do not know.
However, that is no longer important. No matter which country is hit, it would be a severe blow to all of us.
So now I ask you, members of the military, if you see it in your hearts, please utilize the resources available to you and help out our brave pilots. Right now they are flying east to meet the enemy.
To those who still dare to hide behind the power of their hateful weapons, bring yourself before the light of peace and harmony.
Those are Yuk fighters.
This is the Yuktobanian 703rd Squadron. We heard the President's speech. We will fight with you.
Let us sing that song too. We're going with you.
So are we.
Attack the Solg control system, located in a giant tunnel under the Valdrak Mountains. The tunnel entrance is located at the foot of the mountains and the entire area is covered by mountains and waterways. First, an armored force will try to move in from the town to infiltrate the wharf where the entrance to the control system is located. There are several enemy defense positions built along the path that the armored force will take, so air support will be vital for their invasion. Meanwhile, a helicopter formation will attack the control system entrance and capture the nearby area. We're also expecting the helicopters to face anti-air resistance, so we'll need support to put down enemy fire around the entrance. Your squadron's mission is to protect the armored force and clear out a landing area for the Helleborn fleet. Once both units capture the facility entrance, a special forces team will open up the shutter blocking the way inside. Go through the open entrance and destroy the Solg control system from the inside.
Ruger Industries has detected your approach and they're asking for help. Warmonger is still left in both Osea and Yuktavania. Said they'd hand over the third V1 tactical nuke in exchange. They're hiding the more powerful V2 from them. Now listen. We're gonna be sending out fighter jets.
This is the sky that will determine our fate.
We've got to win this battle and bring back peace!
As the commander-in-chief of the Ocean Army, I hereby order all units to lower their weapons and cease fighting.
Don't worry about the Uke fighters and the War Dog Ghosts. Follow me, we're going to put an end to all wars once and for all.
Trained by the
Grabok
aggressors.
Fox 2!
Sam, destroy!
Warning, inbound missile!
The advancing Ocean and Yuktavanian forces have gathered in the industrial sector. It seems that, once again, this area is caught up in the flames of war.
Let's ask the ground forces to retrieve them later.
This is the 112th Infantry Battalion. We were preparing to launch into Yuktavania, but the President's words convinced us to change our battle mission. Now commencing attack on the enemy facility.
Our first fighter wing units, listen up! There go the air assault choppers. We're going in too.
Just shoot down that lead plane and this will be all over.
They'll learn soon enough. Our ace can't be shot down.
We can see AA weapons at the draw point. Air units, sweep up the area around the facility for us. Okay, we're leaving it to you. Looks like they were deployed recently. A lot more than we heard.
Alright, there it is. Lock loaded, stand by.
Territory now. We're not letting the Yanks have their way.
The guys that allied with the villains are biting at each other. Look at them. Like a bunch of dogs from hell.
Damn it. Looks like we really did open the gates of hell. How can we have come to this? It's them. They've dragged us all into this. The War Dog Ghosts. The Ghosts of Rosgrees.
The Ghosts of Rosgrees.
At once.
We'll protect them.
We're with you.
the control facility.
You're gonna be disturbing a lot of people.
The ground force is being delayed by a defensive line of fuel boxes. They need some close air support bombing.
According to the sources close to the president, the Raz Grease consists of four...
We've come across a blueprint of the tunnel facility on the Major's disk. The Solg control system is in the deepest part of the tunnel. We can't touch it from the entrance. Fly into the tunnel, attack the control system in the deepest part of the complex, and escape out the tunnel exit on the opposite side. This is extremely dangerous, but there's no other way to do this. There are two central components to the control system. You must destroy them both, but you can only destroy one of them per attack run. Furthermore, the ground forces will not be able to keep the entrance shutters open for very long. There's not enough time for you to go back into the tunnel again after the first run. So, a separate plane will have to go in from the other side at the same time. We have only one chance. Synchronize your run with the second plane to attack both components simultaneously and destroy the Solg control system.
Still in the tunnel.
Enemy planes dead ahead. We're being
Emergency transmission from Central. The Solg's descent was detected by our radar at 0445 hours. We believe it was programmed to automatically descend if control was ever cut off from the surface. We have calculated the Solg's course of descent from its previous orbit. Its estimated landing point is downtown Aurad, the capital of Osea. Get to the Solg's descent point as quickly as possible and destroy it before it hits Aurad. You must complete the mission and come back alive. Anything less is not acceptable. Rosgrees, we wish you the best of luck. Launch.
Your final sortie. It's almost kind of sad, huh? All right, launch preparations complete.
Roger. Edge engaging.
Roger.
See my brother come back home from Yuktabania.
You ought to go make her happy too. We're almost done here.
The Sulk has fallen to an altitude low enough for you to attack. I know you can do this. Destroy it! I've received a data link from your guide, Vaults, with the Sulk's structural details. The Sulk's outer shell has a rotating accelerator. The only way you can attack its core structure directly is through the gaps in this accelerator. That's bad news. This'll be tough.
We gotta stop that thing, Grim!
I know!
in by some falling fragments.
The Sword is 80 miles from the capital city, Aurib.
Watch the rotation timing and we should be able to hit it.
We have to aim through that? This is like threading a needle.
We're still not doing enough damage to stop it, but...
we're the only ones who can.
That's right! We have to stop it! I'm used to desperate situations, but this one is the worst!
It's falling. It's so huge!
We gotta destroy it! Don't let it hit the ground in one piece! The enemy's laid his strongest cards against us, but no matter.
I won't let them finish us. Not here! I can still move! I can still fly!
We're gonna do this! Just believe in yourself!
Solar panels destroyed!
Well, this is getting a little more encouraging now. I'm not through yet! This is for all my men who fell before me!
You can see the solar fragments reflecting light here.
All that's left of their hatred is this thing in front of us.
Raz-Grees reveals itself, first as a dark demon. As a demon, it uses its power to rain death upon the land, and then it dies. However, after a period of slumber, Raz-Grees returns, this time as a great hero. peace has once again spread across the world. The aces of Rosgrease never flew in the skies of battle again. Above the clouds, there was only a clear blue sky, no longer in need of heroes. And perhaps that's exactly what they were hoping for all this time.
Woo!